The St. Augustine cab driver who was attacked and then had his cab stolen and wrecked says he believes the man wanted money.
St. Augustine police released those new details the same time they released surveillance video from the attack outside a store. Channel 4's Kumasi Aaron is joining us live now from St. Johns County to roll the video. Kumasi?
Robin Jen, this is where the man was finally able to escape, but as you said, that nightmare started long before he got here to Carmelo's. He said as soon as he picked this man up in his car, he attacked him from behind, choking him, and he drove here to Carmelo's because it was one of the few places that he knew would be open at 5 o'clock in the morning, and because he knew that Carmelo's had security cameras.
This is the video taken from a camera at Carmelo's. You see driver Paul Rayner yesterday morning trying to get out of his cab after he says his passenger attacked him. Police say you can see 22-year-old Eugene Wilson kneeing and punching Rayner. They say the attack went on for miles when they say Wilson jumped from the back seat and put his arms around Rayner's neck.
When he was choking me, he kept telling me, just die, you just die. So I knew he was actually trying to kill me.
Barely able to breathe, Rayner drove to Carmelo's because he knew they had security cameras. You can see Wilson follow him from the car into the store where the punches keep coming. A fellow cab driver comes to help, and you can see Wilson attack him too. Once outside, Wilson hops in the cab and drives off. Minutes later, he crashes the car nearby. Now it sits at Yellow Cab offices, a reminder to manager Sharon Lawson of why safety is so important.
We tell them to what to look for. What to lock the door behind them, to pull up on the side of the road where they're getting in on the other side, where they get a good look at it.
I'm sore all the way from top of my neck to about halfway down my shoulder blades.
Now Rayner is left with the physical and mental reminders of that morning attack. He's decided to quit his job as a cab driver for his family, who gave him the motivation to fight for his life.
I was thinking about how bad my children needed me and how I wasn't going to give up. And I think I thought about them, and I thought that, no, I'm not going to die, when he was telling me that I was going to die. I just knew that I wasn't ready.
Now, Rayner told me he'd actually picked Wilson up in his cab before, so he really had no reason to feel threatened by picking him up again. Right now, Wilson is in the hospital, but as soon as he is released, he will be arrested and charged with robbery and battery. Reporting live in St. Johns County, Kumasi Aaron, Channel 4, the local station.
Kumasi, what have you learned about Eugene Wilson's past? I mean, has he ever been arrested for anything like this before?
Jen, the police told me that he actually has been arrested, but most of those arrests were misdemeanors. They said he had no violent felonies.
Kumasi Aaron joining us from St. Augustine. Thank you.